my name is Aubrey, and welcome back to Greenwood Reads, where we try and help you find your next favorite read. I grabbed a couple of our newer books, so hopefully something in there interests you. I know they all caught my eye. So this is what I've got today. For our fiction books, the first one I grabbed is The Grandmother Plot by Caroline B. Cooney. Not gonna lie, I grabbed this one because it's by the author of The Face on the Milk Carton. I can't tell you how many times I read those books as a teenager. So many times. They're ridiculous, I acknowledge that, but they were still a lot of fun. This one is about a young man who spent his whole life sort of avoiding responsibility and never settling down, and he ends up kind of being in charge of his grandmother. She's in a nursing home, she has dementia, so she's starting to slowly lose her memories. And there is, I believe, yes, there is a murder in the nursing home. So it doesn't really look good for him just because, you know, he's bounced around to a lot of jobs. His life is kind of sketchy. So he's trying not to draw attention to himself while at the same time help solve the murder of his grandmother's friend, as the grandmother is also losing, you know, her own memories of herself and her life. So it sounds really interesting. I loved her books as a teenager, so looking forward to reading this one. It should be fun. Again, that is The Grandmother Plot by Caroline B. Cooney. The next one I grabbed also because of the author. It is a honker. It's huge. I'm going to check. How many pages is this thing? Because it looks enormous. It's also illustrated, which is awesome. 734 pages. And it, like I said, it is actually illustrated throughout there. And it is called Empire of the Vampire by Jay Kristoff. I have read several of his books, the Nevernight Trilogy, the Illuminae Files that he wrote with Amy Kaufman, which they're all phenomenal. You should really read them. This one involves vampires. It has apparently been 30 years since the sun has risen in this world. The vampires have sort of taken over and have been waging war on the humans, and apparently we're not doing very well, but it sounds like the whole story is told from the point of view of a prisoner who was fighting against the vampires and is now stuck in this prison and telling the story of how he got to where he is. So I'm looking forward to that one. Jay Kristoff is always very action-y, quite violent, but the stories are always really interesting and fast-paced, so looking forward to that one. I might have to wait, because there are going to be 3 books in the series, and this is just the first one. I don't like restarting a series before all the books are out, because I tend to forget things, but it could take me a very long time. So, Empire of the Vampire. Very exciting. This next one is a nonfiction book called Nuclear Folly, A History of the Cuban Missile Crisis, and I grabbed this one because I don't remember much. I remember learning a little bit about it in high school, and I feel like everyone my age had to watch the movie, I think it was called 13 Hours, 13 Days, 13 something, this is bad. But I remember a movie, and I didn't take a whole lot of American history classes in retrospect in college. I took a lot of European history classes, so I feel like I don't have enough context about what was going on at the time, and that would be really interesting, just that it was such a tense time and that it did come so close to something bad happening. I'd be interested to see what happened sort of surrounding that. So that is Nuclear Folly by Sergei Plokhii, I think. I apologize. I probably just massacred that poor person's name. 1,000 apologies on that one. My last book is called Mercury Rising, John Glenn, John Kennedy, and the New Battleground of the Cold War by Jeff Schessel. I grabbed this one. I was looking for something specifically spacey. We're doing an awesome program on October 16th. It's International Observe the Moon Night. So we're going to have some telescopes, some crafts. It's cool. We'll get an up-close and personal look at the moon. So I wanted to learn about heading there the first time. Mostly because it kind of blows my mind that this was in the 60s, so that was not terribly long ago that we first decided, hey, maybe we could rocket somebody off the planet and they might not die. It's a terrifying concept the more you think about it, especially given how far we've come since then. So I'm really looking forward to that one, figuring out how we got to the moon the first time. So those are my picks for this month. I hope something in there catches your eye and find a new favorite book to read. Thank you very much.